Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Should please once again. In one of my previous videos, I discussed about the advantages of gaming, but I think that I couldn't explain my point that clearly, so I thought of making another part. In this part, I'm gonna mainly explain three things. Number one, why do people think that gamers have no future? Number two, I'm gonna explain some of the famous quotes from certain games and through certain movies, through which I will explain to you guys a gamer's feeling. And number three, some other more advantages which all of you are gonna love. So stay tuned till the end. Before I start this video, don't forget to like this video, share with your friends, subscribe for some more awesome content, and let's roll the intro. The popularity of playing video games has grown immensely over the past decades. We should be proud that India stands on number 2 in this entire world in case of gaming. So we should be proud of that fact. Now, coming on to the point, why do people think gamers have no future, or most importantly, the society at large? Now I'm gonna show you this picture. This picture has a very, very deep meaning. In this picture, as you can see, there is one guy standing in between and the others are the society who think that gamers have no future. But they are entirely wrong. Okay, now I want you to pause a few minutes of your life and think, why do gamers have no future? The time starts now. Pause the video if you want to and think that. Why do people think, or more importantly, the society think that gamers have no future? You may pause the video. Okay, so your time's over. Now, have you thought about the answer? I'm gonna give you my answer. So, now I'm gonna tell you all some names. Currently, I have 52 subs, and I know those 52 subs probably must know these names: Purple Rodri, Hawk's Nest, iFog, Manji TV, Munching Orange, The Odds Were Out. I mean, not The Odds Were Out, but before those. So these all guys are also gamers. The thing is that 90% of the society doesn't know what even if they know what's gaming, still they don't support it. The reason being because at their times they haven't played that much of games. For them, there were classic games like cricket, football, but for us there are classic games like Dota 2, Mario. Those are some of the classic games I've played when I was like around 9 or 10 years old. But now there is this new generation of games like COD Mobile, PUBG Mobile, which is gonna get unbanned very soon. And then you have Clash Royale, Clash of Clans, War of Survival, Rules of Survival, Fortnite Mobile, etc. Most of the people are unfamiliar about these games because they haven't heard the name of these games before. And these games are somewhat built to make the people who play this game feel stress relieved and feel more comfortable while playing these games. So playing this game, a lot of advantages of which I'm gonna tell you guys later on in this video. So the main reason why the people think that gamers have no future, or the society, is because the society thinks that gaming is a burden, and gaming is not a burden. In reality, gaming is fun. I mean, you don't need to be that heck of a professional to play games. You just need to know the basics and apply your full potential and knowledge into that game. For example, you guys only tell me there's this game, I can't remember the game, but it's like you have to connect, like you have to make shapes and then you have to put them in some place. I hope you guys can relate. Or you have to connect two dots, but there are various puzzles and you have to solve it. Tell me, doesn't these games are good? Even if you think that COD Mobile, PUBG Mobile are bad, you're totally wrong. Why? Because I'm gonna explain you this later. So the very main reason why the society thinks is because of the, what do you say, rumors that have been spread across the society that gamers have no future. These rumors have been spread. Around 10% of the population in America, there has been a study in America where 10% of the gamers use electronics because they're rich, and the ones which are poor, once in an interview said that we weren't able to play these games since the society thought that we were a burden to them. One of the gamer was so depressed that he suicided because of that. So if the society builds pressure to someone who wants to take gaming as a career or a future, you should not let that person waste his passion. That passion can become something great to the future. For example, Soul Mortal, Carrie Minati, The Ronnie Show, Tanmay Bhatt, all of these professional gamers, I mean, I won't call them professional, but they are good gamers, entertain us while winning the game at the same time. So if you are able to hit that spot, then the people around you will be exhilarated. They will be so exhilarated that their happiness will have no limits. So here you go. I have the perfect answer. I've given the perfect answer for this question. Now let's move on to the question number 2. Okay, so now I'm gonna start explaining those quotes. Some of these quotes are from some video games and from some movies. So, and some of these are casual but yet have a deep meaning. And I'm gonna relate all of these quotes to gaming so that I can understand all of you that how a gamer actually feels in real life. Number one quote, I don't need to get a life, I'm a gamer, I have lots of lives. Some of these used, since we have played these games, we are not actually scared, to be honest. If there is a zombie apocalypse, I actually won't be scared, to be very precise, because I have played lots of games where I have encountered zombies 1,000 or 1,000,000 times, and I'm not lying. And if this ever happens, like if there is a zombie apocalypse, I'm ready to instead of hiding. This means that we are so self-confident in ourselves that nothing can stop us. Number 3, I'll make it clear, I'm not a toy. My feelings are not your playground and my life isn't your game. I will make it clear, I'm not a toy. This is not that self-explanatory, but I am gonna explain it to you guys. We gamers are not tools used by gaming industry or someone else. We are someone who work on four quote, I guess. Yeah, it's the number 4 quote. I'm a gamer because I don't have a life. I have chosen to have many. This is pretty self-explanatory. Again, a gamer enjoys a game because he doesn't. Because in a game, it's not like that. Once you die, you can't come. Yeah, there are some options which can make a game hardcore, but in casual games, a game offers you respawns. For example, respawns in Call of Duty, Minecraft, and many other games. That's why a gamer enjoys to play a game the most. Then coming are some of my personal favorite quotes. Number 5. Even the good leaders make poor decisions. It's the best leaders that take responsibility for them. Kratos, God of War. This is one of the best quotes I have ever found out. This means that all of us need to have certain responsibilities, and for that responsibilities we need to have good decision making skills. If we are called a good leader, then we should have some skills. For example, if A calls B a good leader, then that doesn't make B a good leader since B has no skills. But if C has good responsibility and decision-making skills, then he can surely be called as a leader. Decision-making skills are very important throughout life. From being a child, to being a teenage, to being an adult, from being an old man or an old woman. These things actually do matter in life a lot. These things, you know, can't be realized at the age of 14 or 15, max, but after 15, you actually start to realize these things because all of these things are interrelated.
Now, coming on to the number sixth quote. It's a road that will not always take me where I wish to go, and I doubt I will live to see it end, but I will travel down it nonetheless. Raton hena keton. Okay, please don't mind my pronunciation. I haven't played Assassination Creed, but according to me, I guess it's Raton or it's Raton hena hake ton. Okay, please correct my pronunciation if I'm wrong. It's a road that will not always take me where I wish to go. Gamers have many ups and downs. There is a particular stage where all the gamers have to face addiction at a certain point. After facing addiction and after passing that stage of life, gamers know how to control their will. If they have passed that level of self-addiction, then nothing can stop them. There is always this road that makes them fear. For example, I'm taking the road as society. Society doesn't want a person to be a gamer, but if the person really wants to be a gamer, nothing can stop him. The gamer will go and see the depths of where he can do gaming, what's his future, what's his career. He or she will travel down till the end, till he or she knows what to do and what not to do. Now, coming on to the next quote. The next quote is of a very great scientist, and he is one of my favorite scientists. It's Albert Einstein. You have to learn the rules of the game, and then you have to play better than anyone else. This is self-explanatory, plus it has a deep meaning inside. You have to learn the rules of the game, and then you have to play better than anyone else, which means, for example, if you're starting Call of Duty Mobile or Clash Royale or Clash of Clans, then you have to know the basic rules, and then you have to improve your skills. But this has a deep meaning. Life is a game of difficulties and struggles. You need to surpass each and every one of them. Once you have faced these difficulties and struggles, nothing can beat you. Coming on to a very deep quote. It's of Minecraft. You invade this pristine world, claiming it as your own simply by your presence. You slaughter innocent animals for their hides and their flesh. You devastate the landscape and gouge out the earth to build your monuments to vanity, and yet you call me the monster. This is a very deep meaning, this quote. Creeper, the name of the monster is Creeper. Creepers in Minecraft are very annoying. Generally, once they see you, they just blow up and take you down. Here, this creeper, through his or her message, wants to convey that in Minecraft, basically it's a survival game. So in Minecraft, we hunt down animals to eat, we cut down trees and cause deforestation, we take water from the sacred rivers, we devastate the landscape, we destroy the monuments, and yet we call Creeper the monster. In Minecraft, we haven't thought about this, that we are not making up the world, we are actually kind of destroying the world. Because the monsters have their natural powers, but why should we destroy their habitat? Naturally, if you are not, for example, if you are not a member of a lion, or lion pride, then the lion will eventually kill you. It won't even hesitate. It will just kill you. Yet the creeper says that we deforestate the trees, we hunt down the animals, and yet we call creepers the monsters. This thing can be related to the society, where the society does everything, does every bad and good thing, but still blame gamers to be aborted. Now coming are two of my favorite quotes of all time. The price of freedom is high. It always has been, and it's a price I'm willing to pay. The price of freedom is high, which means a gamer has to struggle a lot in his or her life to be what he or she wants to be. It's always has been, and it's a price I'm willing to pay.
a gamer can do anything to be a gamer, from consoling that to his or her mom and to becoming a gamer is one heck of a challenge. Now coming on to the most notable quotes of all time, and one of my favorite quotes from Harry Potter: happiness can be found even in the darkest of times, if one remembers to turn on the light. By Albus Percival Wulfric Brian Dumbledore. This is such a legendary quote. Happiness can be found even in the darkest of times. There is a certain period of time where we gamers have to go through a lot of things. At first, my mom scolded me on when I started YouTube, but then I slowly and steadily made her realize that it's not a bad thing. It's my passion and I want to unleash my creativity in any way. Happiness can be found even in the darkest of times. I found my happiness when I gained 30 subs, to be precise. Because at that time I got more and more motivation and I started to make more quality content videos. If only one remembers to turn on the light. I always remember to make the best of the best videos, to export them to the best, to use as many as things I can. But of a gamer's life, a gamer finds this happiness when his or her mom or dad tells that he or she can become a gamer if only one remembers to turn on the light, which means that the gamer, after becoming who he or she wanted to be, has to take a lot of responsibilities. For example, not getting addicted, playing for a minimum hour, making a time schedule for everything. So these were some of the most notable quotes which had a deep meaning inside them. Let's talk about some of the advantages of games. Number one, especially after a hectic day, most of the people don't feel like doing anything. But there are certain games, for example, don't laugh, because I'm gonna name some games which kids play, but those games actually stress relieves you. For example, Candy Crush Saga, Plants vs. Zombies series, and Minecraft. These games help to stress relieve you. For example, in Candy Crush, you have to go through certain levels by, matching up candies. Then in Plants vs. Zombies, you have to attack the zombies with some plants. And in Minecraft, it's a survival game. So these games actually stress relieve you. These games actually do stress relieve you, so that after this hectic day of yours, you actually feel comfortable playing these games. And now let's talk about another point. It's a social skill. Now, I've explained this point in my first video of advantages of game, but I haven't explained it that good. In social skills, through certain games, as I've already mentioned, like story-based games, our fluency increases, fluency of English, our vocabulary and English grammar also becomes better. We get to make new friends through online games such as PUBG Mobile, Fortnite, COD Mobile, and our social skills also increases. Then our communication skills and decision making skills through a game. For example, while playing through Battle Royale, a person needs good communication and decision making skills in order to win that game, or at least reach to the top 5 or top 2 spot. This can be related in real life. If you play these games for 1 hour, for a minimum of an hour, your brain will be refreshed and you can take better decisions and communication than the, like, you can take better, you will be better in decision making and communication skills than the rest of the people around you. So that's good. Your skill increases in the sense all of these skills increases via survival games like COD Mobile, Clash of Clans, Clash Royale, etc. As I had already mentioned to you guys. So, your social skills and all of these, anxiety, depression, all of these can be removed through games. My final thoughts. Now, I'm gonna give you my final thought of what I think about gaming. First, I discuss that why does the society think that the gamers are a burden, or like why do the people think that gamers have no future? I just talked about this. Then I talked about the quotes to relate a gamer's life. Then I talked about the advantages of games. And now I'm gonna give you guys my final thoughts. See, fighting depression is very difficult and it can impact everything from your day-to-day life to self-harm and suicidal thoughts. When treatment options feel heavy, threatening, or even stressful, it's very less likely that an individual will seek out help. Also, children and teenagers may not know how to express what they're going through, and depression can remain undiagnosed. However, video games, whether they are regular games or specifically designed to improve symptoms of depression, may help some people feel better and engage with life in a more meaningful way. It may be a powerful way to combat depression. A game like Words with Friends can help players connect with others socially, while Minecraft can increase an individual's creativity. Gamers can improve their confidence and problem-solving skills, making them more adapted to deal with real life instead of feeling the need to escape. To play or not to play. Some people who are depressed may turn to video games as a way to self-medicate themselves. This is why some research can be skewed. It can look like gamers have a high likelihood of depression, which can lead to the assumption that gaming has caused it. However, it's also possible that a lot of people with depression turn to gaming and actually experience a decrease in symptoms. Turning into gaming for medicinal purposes becomes a problem when a gamer attempts to escape their life instead of treating their issues. So, these were some of my final thoughts. With that said, comes an end to this video. Do share it with your family and friends, because this video needs to be spread to everyone to explain about gaming. This is me, Shubhanya, signing off. Live your life of purpose and bye.